Hi, it's Malaysia Gojin doing a different kind of fried rice that is super duper good that you get to taste the sea. I'm talking about seaweed fried rice lah. Boring lah, asyik-asyik makan the same fried rice je kan? Now you have something new to try. As usual, ingredient list is in the description box below. Now we're gonna need one carrot. I'm doing for two person, but I'm using one carrot because my carrot is quite thin. We're gonna dice finely. First, we're gonna grate the skin off, of course, and then cut them into three or four parts. And then make a flat surface so that your carrots won't be moving around when you slice them in slices like this. And then you turn them around and julienne them. And then you go for the cute cuts, but in this case, it's gonna be diced finely. So the carrot cut is not too big nor too small, perfect for this dish. Next, we're gonna chop some spring onions. Half tangkai ko, no need a lot lah. Okay, now there's a variety of protein choices that you could go for. In my case, I'm using sausage. You can use prawns or spam. That's actually not halal lah, for our non-Muslim friends only. Or for vegetarian friends, you can go for the vegetarian mock meats. How to cut them? Same as how you cut your carrots, okay? Dice finely. Eh, but you guys know what? Next round when I cook this, I'm gonna try using fish meat. I think it's gonna be good too. So I'm using only half onion, it's up to you. And then I dice it finely. Well, I'm not articulate enough to explain to you guys how to cut it. Just watch how I do. Okay? Nampak tak? My hand pose also give kau-kau because I need a good angle to show you guys. Alright, this is our main hero in this dish, the Chinese dried seaweed. Now, I'm emphasizing on Chinese because it is important to pick the right seaweed for this dish. Chinese one is usually, if you buy online, it's round like this, or in supermarket, I don't know how to describe which section, but it's also round like this. It comes in dark purple color before cooked, and you need to roast it with a little bit of oil on the pan. And then when you're roasting it, then it will turn dark green. That's when it's cooked. So again, find China one, okay? Not Korea, not Japan. It's China punya! Wow, you see? Nice, huh? Actually, at this point, you can sprinkle some salt and can eat it as snacks, you know, like the ones that you buy from supermarket, the Korean ones. And then what you can do is you need to crush it. But before crushing it, let it cool down first. You have to kasi cubit here and there until it really crush until small pieces. Because big pieces, big chunks, that best are the taste. Wow, I swear to you, I was licking my fingers like crazy after that. Now, if you're cooking for one person like me, use an egg. But if you're cooking for more people, okay, you add the quantity of the egg accordingly. But what you're gonna do this step is to separate the yolk and the white so that you can put the yolk into the overnight rice that you have already macam kasi loosen up the rice, and then you mix up the yolk with the rice. Make sure the yolk covers every grain of the rice. Okay, heat up some oil with your kuali. Now we're gonna stir fry the ingredients first, the onions and the carrots. Stir fry until you can smell the aroma. And then in goes the protein. Saute again until your choice of protein is cooked, or until you can smell your choice of protein. Take out, put it aside. Okay, round two. The same wok with a little bit of oil. In goes the yolk rice. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna spread it out and then let it sit for a while. And then that's when you start flipping them around so that the yolk is cooked evenly on each grain. And then in goes the egg white. And then you kasi saute around lah. Wah, cantik. All the grains are like on its own. Solo grains. And then in goes the ingredients that you have stir-fried earlier. Just toss it around sekejap, okay? Toss sana, toss sini. And then in goes the crushed seaweed, but not all. I'm saving some for garnishing later. Again, toss sana, toss sini. Next step, This one have to be careful, if not, the whole soy sauce masuk the kuali. Put in 1 tablespoon or around 2 tablespoons, depending on your liking of soy sauce. Last, campak the spring onions inside and then just toss sana, toss sini for about 10 seconds and then you can off the flame already. Okay, did I tell you that this dish is healthy? And how I got to learn about this recipe is I was watching this China punya food documentary and then they were showing this and I was so impressed with how they produce this dried seaweed and I can get it here, so why not seaweed fried rice? The taste of this seaweed fried rice is really refreshing because it's not like the typical fried rice that we keep doing at home in Malaysia, and the yolk cover rice grain technique is very, very impressive that you have to try it out. Happy cooking!